हेलो एवरीवन, अगेन वेलकम टू आवर टुडेज लेक्चर दैट इज यूनिट नंबर 5, डिजाइन ऑफ स्प्रिंग्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न व्हाट एग्जैक्टली मीन बाय कर्वेचर इफेक्ट एंड डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ स्प्रिंग। माई सेल्फ मिस्टर विपिन पाटिल, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग एट चरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी पॉलिटेक्निक एटा। सो लेट अस सी व्हाट कंटेंट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टुडे। सो हियर इट इज द टुडेज कंटेंट। सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टुडे इफेक्ट ऑफ कर्वेचर, देन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वॉल्स करेक्शन फैक्टर, देन डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ हेलिकल कॉम्प्रेशन स्प्रिंग। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द कर्वेचर इफेक्ट ऑफ ए कॉइल। So in last lecture we have seen that the maximum stress induced in helical spring, that is tau. So here you can see the equation number 1, that is tau. We have derived it in previous lecture. You can see here tau is equal to 8wd pi d cube 1 plus 1 upon 2c, that is equal to ks into 8wd pi d cube, where the ks is shear factor, shear stress factor, as we have discussed earlier, and we have substituted the capital C is equal to capital D by d, that is called spring index. In above equation number 1, we have considered two types of stresses only. So we have considered torsional shear stress, that is because the load W. Then we have considered direct shear stress due to the direct load W. So the effect of curvature of a coil on stress distribution. Let us see how exactly the effect of curvature takes place. So we have not considered stress induced in spring due to curvature of wire in equation number 1. So here we have not seen the effect of curvature of a wire. So we are going to modify this formula further. So in equation number 1, when a bar is bent in the form of helical coil, the curvature of coil increases stress in inner side of a spring. So considered, this is the fibers of a spring. We are giving load here, that is W. So these are the coil springs or the coils of a spring. You can see here the farthest fiber and it is the inner fiber. So as we see, the inner side of spring at the same time, so here the curvature of coil increases the stress in inner side. So you can see this is the inner side, the stresses are increased in inner side, and at the same time the curvature of coil decreases stress on outer side of the spring. So you will see here the outer side stresses are relieved, thus the length of inner fiber is less than the length of outer fiber. So you can see here, this is the length of a inner fiber, which is less than the outer fiber. Therefore, inner fiber gets subjected to stress concentration. Because of this stress, more stress, the inner side is get stress concentrated. The effect of stress concentration is severe and considerably larger for high value spreading index. So you will see here. Here it is the inner fiber and the stress concentration is higher here. So therefore, a Wall's stress factor is introduced. Wall's stress factor is introduced in the above equation 1, and the equation is modified as, so you can see here the equation, that is tau is equal to k 8wd upon pi d cube. So we are replacing this d term by सी. सो सी इज नथिंग बट द स्प्रिंग इंडेक्स, वेर के इज वॉल्स करेक्शन फैक्टर, और यू कैन से इज अ वॉल्स स्ट्रेस फैक्टर और स्प्रिंग स्ट्रेस फैक्टर. सो के इज कैलकुलेटेड एज k इज इक्वल टू 4c माइनस 1 अपॉन 4c माइनस 4 प्लस 0.615c. हियर इट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ k. यू कैन फाइंड आउट बाय सिलेक्टिंग द स्प्रिंग इंडेक्स. यू कैन पुट आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट k हियर. सो द वॉल स्ट्रेस फैक्टर इज मॉडिफाइड यूजिंग, वी हैव रिप्लेस्ड k हियर एंड वी हैव putted k, so the k is nothing but Wall's correction factor. So let us see how the graph of a Wall's correction factor comes. So the value of k for a given spring index c may be obtained from the graph as shown in figure. Here you can see the stress factor k and you can see here the spring index c. So from 0 to 16 the spring index is placed, and from 1 to 1.8 it is the stress factor, that is capital K, which we have seen earlier here. So the value of this K or spring factor is depends upon the spring index. We see from figure that the Wall's correction factor increases very rapidly as the spring index decreases. Here you can see when the spring index is decreases, the Wall's correction factor increases rapidly. The spring mostly used in a machinery having the spring index above 3. So here you can see the spring index is higher, or we can say it as a stress factor. Here you can find out the value of factor k is 1.5. So you can find out, or you can select the spring index above 3. Here you can see the value of stress factor is decreases as the spring index of a machine increases. So the wall stress factor K may be considered as a composed of two surfactors, that are Ks and Kc. So the equation becomes K is equal to Ks into Kc, where the Ks is stress factor due to the shear and the Kc is nothing but the stress concentration factor due to the curvature. So you can find out the stress factor like this also. So how to plot the graph of the Wall's factor versus the spring index? We will put the values of C. You can see we can put the values of C as 3, 4 up to 16. So the equation of a Wall's factor, here it is the equation of a Wall's factor. So K is equal to 4C. Here you can put the value of C as a 3. And you can calculate the stress correction factor. Here you can put the 3, here you can put 3, also you can put 3. So the graph will become, it is the stress factor, that is the spring index. When you put the value of 3, you will get exact value of spring stress factor. So likewise, the calculation of K is done and the Wall's correction factor is calculated. So let us see what are the values of a stress factor with respect to the spring index. So values of Wall's factor for varying spring index are, for 3 it is 1.58, for 4 it is 1.4, for 5 it is 1.31, For 6, it is 1.25. For 7, it is 1.21. For 8, it is 1.18. For 9, it is 1.16. For 10, it is 1.14. So, as you can identify, as the spring index increases, the wall stress factor gate decreases. So, this formula is used to carry out the constant K, that is Wall's correction factor, and it is used in calculation where the Wall's correction factor is taken in consideration, and it is not used in direct shear stress or the maximum shear stress calculation. Let us see the deflection of a compression helical spring. So in previous lecture we have discussed the maximum shear stress developed in the wire. So we know that, actually we have seen the formula of tau. So in this calculation we are going to discuss deflection of a spring. So the total active length of a wire is equal to L is equal to length of a one coil into number of active coils. Here number of active coils are n, small n, and the length of coil is nothing but pi d, circumferential length you can say. So give it as a equation number one. Here you can see the load applied on an axis of a helical spring, and this is the helix angle. The spring is twisted here and applied equilibrium torque by the spring material. Here you can see the T, that is equilibrium torque. So theta is angular deflection of a wire when acted upon the torque. You can see here the theta, and axial deflection of the spring is equal to, so deflection is nothing but the delta. You can find out the formula of a deflection. It is equal to theta into d by 2, whereas the d is nothing but the mean diameter of a spring. Here you can see the mean diameter. It is not a coil diameter, it is spring diameter. So give it as equation number 2. Once again, delta is equal to theta into d by 2. Also we know that the torque is nothing but force into perpendicular distance. Here the applied force is nothing but W into d by 2. So here it is the radial distance, that is perpendicular to load acted. So it is the equation number 3. So as per the formulae, conventional formulae, you can see here T by J is equal to tau by R. D by 2 is nothing but R. D by 2 is equal to small r. You can see here tau by R is equal to G theta by L. This is the torsional equation, that is standard one. So we can say that theta is equal to T by TL upon J by upon J into G. Here J is nothing but the polar moment of inertia of a spring wire. It is having circular cross section, so that the J is equal to pi by 32 into D raised to 4, where D being the diameter of a spring wire and G is nothing but the modulus of rigidity of that particular material. So once again take a glance on it, pi D into N. This is the equation number 1. Then delta is equal to theta into d by 2, equation number 2, and we have calculated the equilibrium torque, that is T is equal to W by 2, and the conventional equation, that is T by J is equal to tau by R is equal to G theta by L. So we have taken in terms of theta, the theta is equal to TL upon JG. Now substituting the values of small l and j in above equation. So here is that theta, and we are going to substitute the value of L and value of J. So the equation become, you can see TL by JG. So here you can find out T is nothing but, equation number 3, T is nothing but W into D by 2. So you can find here W into D by 2 into L. So you can find here L is nothing but pi D small n. Here it is pi D small n upon JG. You will find here the value of J, that is polar moment of inertia of a circular shaft or a circular cross section, that is pi by 32 into D raised to 4. And here it is the modulus of rigidity of that particular material. So you will get 16 capital W D square N upon G D raised to 4. This is equation number 4. So substituting this value of theta in equation number 2. So here it is the equation number 2. So we have to replace this value of theta from this equation. So we will get delta is equal to 16 W D square N upon capital G D raised to 4 into D by 2, where it is the value, it is the value of theta as you have earlier calculated here. Theta is, delta is equal to theta into D by 2. So the equation becomes 8 W D cube upon N by G D raised to 4. Further, we are simplifying it. We are going to put this relation using the spring index. It is nothing but capital C is equal to capital D by D. So replacing this one instead of D cube. So we are going to calculate C cube, that is C cube is nothing but D cube upon small D cube. Here we have taken common D cube by D cube, and remaining small d is put it here. So the final equation is 8 W C cube into N upon G D. And the stiffness of the spring or the spring rate, capital S, is W upon delta, that is load upon deflection, that is the spring rate, or you can say the stiffness of a spring. It is the standard formulae. So it is equal to capital G D raised to 4. We have taken the reciprocal of the same, capital G into D 4 upon 8 D cube into N. So further, we are going to convert this formulae. Here you can see, and the final equation become W upon delta is equal to capital G D by 8 C 3 cube N, that is constant, that is spring stiffness. So likewise, you can calculate the deflection of a spring using the Wall's correction factor, and the C3 is nothing but the spring rate, or from this you can find out the force upon deflection of that particular spring. So this is all about our today's content. So once again, take a glance on the equations that we have seen. So before conclude this lecture, I want to take one glance. So let us see how exactly we have calculated or we came to conclusion that equation. Here it is, the equation number one is pi dn. It is the length of a coil into number of active coils. So directly you can calculate the total active length of wire. Then we have calculated the deflection, that is delta is equal to theta into d by 2, equation number 2. Then as a conventional formula, T is equal to torque, that is torque, which is formed due to the applied load, applied force, W into d by 2, equation number 3. It is a conventional formula of a torsional shaft torsion. T by J is equal to tau by D2, that is R, small r, that is radius of a wire, then G theta by L. So finally we have got the value of theta, that is TL into TL upon J by G, where J is polar moment of inertia of a spring wire, that is pi by 32 D raised to 4. Then modulus of rigidity of particular material. Here we came to substitute these values in equation number 1. These values in theta equation. So we came to conclusion, that is, this is the value of theta, this is the value of T, and we have got the value of L. Here it is the value of J, and is the modulus of rigidity. Finally, we have got this equation, that is equation number 4. So substituting this value of theta in equation number 2, so this is directly, this theta value is substituted in equation number 2. So delta is equal to 16 WD square small n upon G d raised to 4 into d by 2. So finally we have got this equation, and we have calculated the stiffness of spring or the spring rate, and we have got force upon deflection, that is stiffness definition, and the S is nothing but W by delta, and which is capital GD upon 8 C3 cube N. So this is the final formula. So as per the MSBT point of view, following are the important questions. So state the effect of curvature of a coil on the stress distribution. That is the first question. So you have to write this paragraph here. So you will find the effect of curvature of a coil on the stress distribution. Then the second question, that is, explain how the graph of Walls factor versus spring index is drawn. Here you can see how exactly we have calculated. So you can see here, this one is the answer of same, how exactly we have to calculate the spring index. Here it is the second image on your screen. You can calculate the spring index or the Walls correction factor here by using spring index C. Here it is the table. And the final question is, express the formula of deflection of a helical compression spring. Earlier we have seen the expression. So likewise, you have to calculate the formula of deflection of helical compression spring. So it is all about today's lecture. If any queries, comment down below. Thank you. Thank you very much.